is TV Ontario, Channel 19 in Toronto, Channel 12 in Owen Sound.
I'm Susanna, and this is Tell Me a Story. Are you comfortable and ready for the story? Today, I'm going to tell you how Arabella learned to be brave. Do you know what a chicken hawk is? It's a bird that eats little animals like mice and sometimes gets after the chickens on a farm. Arabella was a pretty little white chicken hawk. Most chicken hawks are brown when they're small, but not this one. She was special right from the start. And she was all white. Arabella never ate chickens. She was afraid to go in the chicken coop. She was afraid of everything. You might say, Arabella was the most chicken-hearted little white chicken hawk in the whole wide world. One day, as she was sitting on a branch, but not too far out in case it should break, Arabella noticed a hole in the tree trunk. Down inside, she could see a nest, and in it were shining, sparkling things. Oh, she said, how I would love to have one of those. She edged closer and closer until she sat right on the rim of the hole. Just then, a raucous voice behind her said, you can't go in there, Arabella. You're too big. Arabella jumped and almost lost her balance. She was so startled. She looked around. There on a branch sat five black crows, all lined up in order of size from the largest to the smallest. The largest crow said, don't be silly, Arabella. You're too big to get in there. And the second largest crow said, you're much too big, Arabella. And the middle-sized crow said, you're much, much too big, Arabella. And the tiniest crow of all, yes, Arabella, you're much, much, much too big. And that made her feel like a great big clumsy clod. Oh, dear, said Arabella, I'm too big, much too big. And she hopped sadly away along the branch, saying, oh, dear, I'm too big, I'm much too big. Now, as soon as Arabella had left the hole, the biggest crow of all hopped inside and took one of the lovely shining things. He hopped out with a ring shining in his beak. Then the next largest crow brought out a bracelet. Each crow took a turn right down to the very tiniest crow of all. Then they all sat on a branch with the shining things in their beaks. And one of them sounded very funny for some time after, because his was a toy whistle. Are you wondering how the shining things got into the nest? Well, all crows love shiny things. When they find something they like, they take it back to their nests. Arabella watched the crows chewing on the bright toys, and she felt very sad. Well, she said, I guess that's what happens when you believe someone who says you can't do something. She flew slowly away, staying close to the ground. Arabella was afraid to fly high up. Well, after that, those crows had Arabella's number. It seemed like no matter where she went, there was a crow around to put her down and take all the fun out of things. At first, she didn't believe them when they said she was wrong every time. But after a while, she began to think there couldn't be even one good thing about her. She couldn't see how pretty she was with her lovely white feathers and wide red eyes. She didn't see how dainty her claws were after they'd told her how clumsy she was. If Arabella went for a drink at the watering trough, it'd be, Arabella, you'll lose your balance. And Arabella, you drink too much water. If she was having fun with the other chicken hawks, some crow would catch her afterwards and say, Arabella, you laugh too loud. Poor thing. It seemed like she just couldn't be happy. Then Then one day, Arabella was watching the other chicken hawks learning to fly. They soared higher and higher until Arabella thought they must be able to touch the clouds. "Oh me," she said, "how I'd love to fly as high as that." "You can't," said one of the teacher hawks. "Those chicken hawks are all your own age." "Oh, I'm much too big and heavy," said Arabella. "I couldn't stay up in that thin air." The teacher hawk smiled and went back to the class. I guess she knew that sooner or later something would happen to make Arabella fly. And she almost did try. She stood right up on tippy-toe on a branch and held her wings out. But just as she was going to start, that same raucous voice said, "Don't be silly, Arabella. You can't fly. You're too small." Then the next largest crow said, "You can't fly, Arabella. You're much too small." And the middle-sized crow said, "You can't fly, Arabella. You're much, much too small." Then the tiniest crow of all piped, "You're too small, Arabella. You're much, much, much too small." And he was even tinier than she was. Then all the crows laughed, and one of them went, "Ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha." He was the one who had taken the toy whistle. "Oh, dear," said Arabella, "I'm too small." And she moved sadly away along the branch, looking at the ground and saying, "Oh, dear, I'm much, much too small." She tucked her little head under her wing and lost all interest in everything. She just sat there drooping. Suddenly, the farm dog caught sight of her. It came running up, barking its fool head off. Well, Arabella took off like a rocket, and before she even knew it, she was flying above the trees and still climbing. She looked below her and saw the other chicken hawks. She looked up and saw nothing but sky. She looked sideways and saw a row of rotten old black crows. "You'll never stay up here, Arabella. Your wings are too weak," said the biggest crow. And all the crows took up the refrain as usual. The next largest crow said, "Don't be silly, Arabella. You can't fly. Your wings are much too weak." The middle-sized crow said, "Your wings are much, much too weak, Arabella." And before it even got to the tiniest crow of all, Arabella's heart failed her and she let her wings droop. She started to fall. But lucky for her, she fell in the tall grass. She looked up in the sky and saw the crows. She tried her wings and found she wasn't tired at all. And then she began to understand. "Well," she said, "now I see that I shouldn't believe everything everyone tells me." Then she took a funny running start and beat her wings furiously. Soon she was high up in the air, flying faster and faster, until she passed the crows, who couldn't think of a thing to say. And that is how Arabella learned to trust herself and try. There are many books about birds and animals in the library. One I particularly enjoyed was Petunia Beware by Roger Duvoisin. I hope you'll find it and many other stories to keep you company until it's time once again for Tell Me a Story.